Good morning, Syndicate members. I know that this is dangerous. I know I shouldn't be making a video while I'm driving. I'm aware of the risks, so don't do this at home, okay? But I just got out of the gym feeling really good, but I did want to make a really important video today because as great as that last opportunity was, the news cues, how we had no errors at all, everything was just perfect. This one, the crime drama album, we did not have a perfect roll, and that's okay. Not that I was expecting it. It's kind of obviously the first time we had a perfect album last time, so I wasn't expecting it every time, but I was a little disappointed that we had a lot more errors this time than we usually do. And the only thing that I can maybe justify or explain why that happened is because I think a lot of you guys, this might have been your first opportunity. There's a few names that I haven't seen so often in our opportunities that get accepted. So I think some of you guys might be your first time at the rodeo, so to speak. So you're just not used to creating finals and stems and following directions and making sure that everything's and all your T's are crossed, I's are dotted. But we had every error that you can think of. We had file names that were mislabeled or not labeled properly. We had stems that were not labeled properly or grouped improperly or just categorized in some strange way. We had some stems that were not in the stem folder, that were in other folders. We had some paperwork that was missing. We had metadata problems. I mean, there's just a lot. Not all of you. A few of you guys got it 100% correctly. And if you did, that's what I told you, is that everything looks and sounds great. And you got your consideration fee right away. But those of you that I sent some feedback back on, yeah, a lot of problems that were going on there. So what I want to make an urgent point today is that I don't want this to sound like I'm some sort of a nitpicky, like, you know, oh, you didn't put a parenthesis right there in your track title, therefore do it over and do this. Because I understand on the receiving end of that can be like, dude, like, is it really that big of a deal? Couldn't you just fix that on your end? Because I used to do that for Syndicate members, because it's like, well, it's a lot easier for me just to kind of fix up your stuff than it is for me to send it back to you and tell you fix it, resend me the new stuff and relabel everything. But I realized as time went on that I'm not doing you guys any favors if I fix your problems for you. And you guys need to learn that these guidelines are not my guidelines, okay? I'm not sitting here saying your track titles need to look like this, or that your stems need to be grouped that way, or that you need to make sure you don't have too much silence at the end of your 30 or 60 second versions, which a few of you guys had that issue too. That's all Library X, okay? Library X needed these things to be done in a very specific way. And when we don't do it in that very specific way, I get pushback from them. And they actually let me know, hey, you guys didn't do it right, do it again. And I really care about how Library X sees me. I really value my reputation with them. I don't want to be a person in their life that sends them homework, that sends them problems, that sends them stuff that needs to be fixed or corrected so that they have to wait for that to be corrected or for them to correct it themselves. I want to be somebody in their life that just sends them solutions, sends them music, sends them good products, sends them stuff that's ready to go, and they just have to put it into their system and boom, they're ready to go. You guys should hopefully want that as well for your careers with the libraries that you directly partner with, right? Whether you're partnering with them now or in the future. And part of the Syndicate is that I'm guessing, I hope you guys joined because you want to be the best. You want to be the best that you possibly can be. You want to be the most competitive in this business. You want to be the most professional. And when you get accepted by a library, which you should be, if you're not accepted by a library yet, you should be telling yourself, I will be accepted by a library. Give those positive affirmations. When you get accepted by the library, you want, I hope so, you want to be in their inner circle. You want to be one of the few that they're like, man, this guy or this girl, they're always there for us. They're always giving us what we need. We're going to get them all of these opportunities. And every time we have something really cool and exciting, they're the first on our list because they always give us properly formatted tracks and they always double check everything and they're awesome, right? I think that's why you guys are here, right? And so if I'm not giving you guys some pushback on that, then I'm not doing my job. So I haven't decided if I'm going to do this yet, but I'm definitely thinking about implementing it for our next opportunity. And it would be something to the effect of one of two things, I think. One would be a much harsher, tough love consequence. But one idea I had, which is probably a little evil, but it would actually would definitely send the message very, very loud and clear, is that for any of you that send me finals, let's say you got accepted to a library, but you send me finals that are not correct, like they're not labeled properly, or they're in the wrong format, or your metadata is off, or anything where I have to take extra time and email you and say, hey, you didn't do this right, do this. Maybe I just don't accept your track onto the album. Maybe I just say, sorry, you didn't get it right. That's your consequence. You gotta learn the lesson. Because with that strict of a consequence, I would hope all of you guys would at least, and this is not like hours and hours of extra work I'm asking, guys. I'm asking for basically about a minute of your time right before you click send on that email. That's what I'm asking for you to do. Right before you click send, double check everything. Listen to your tracks, look at their titles, double check my guidelines, make sure that Library X's guidelines, double check them, make sure everything is exactly how you think they ought to be, and do your best that way. I feel like some of you guys aren't doing that. I feel like some of you guys are excited and you're rushing and you're just clicking send, and there's no quality control check going on here, and so you're just sending out whatever's in that folder, and sometimes it's a nightmare and it's a mess and it's not what I want to see. And I'll just be honest, I get bummed when I see that. I get annoyed. I know that, oh God, okay, it's not going to be as simple as just downloading this, putting it in the folder, zipping it up, sending it. No, I'm going to have to do some more. Okay, I got to type out a new email to you. Hey, you got to fix this. Then I got to get the new stems from you. I got to double check those, replace the old ones. It's 10 times more work when I have to get the corrected files. And I know that libraries, when they get those from you, they're going to feel exactly the same way. Just, oh, more work, right? So that's one really, really strict consequence I could do. I think the more likely one that I would implement is that if you do not send me your files in the exact format that I need, and you give me some sort of a problem or an error, any issue, maybe your consideration fee would be forfeited, right? So if you sent me two files, one of your files, you got everything right, but the other one, you screwed up a couple things, maybe you only get one of the consideration fees, because I have to do work now. I have to do basically some of your homework to fix your files to make sure that you get it done right. So that would be maybe a little less harsh of a consequence, but hopefully enough to kind of wake some of you guys up to the fact that there are real consequences to this stuff. Because again, if I don't do stuff like this, guys, I don't feel like I'm being like a really good teacher. I don't feel like I'm being a mentor. Like, mentors are not there to just hold your hand and tell you everything's fine and don't worry about it, I'll fix your mistake. Like, to me, that's not what a mentor is. A mentor is somebody who can kind of look you in the eye and say, now you screwed this up, like, you got to do it better. And if you don't do it better, you're going to have big problems in your career. That's what I'm trying to say to you guys right now. This stuff might seem like, oh, we're just talking about how files look, or like, you know, the actual characters in a file track name, or we're just talking about a couple of little data points and metadata. Is it really that big a deal? Yes. Yes, yes, it is. And it sounds crazy, it sounds ridiculous, but it's always the little things, guys. The little things in this business is actually what's going to help separate you from the masses, from everybody else. Because I know, I'm not going to pick on those of you or name names or anything, but there's a few of you that I always get problems from. There's always issues with your files. And now when I receive files from you, I'm almost expecting them, because I'm like, yep, last time there was a problem, and there's probably going to be another problem this time. So that's not a good, you don't want to have that reputation, okay? And some of you guys, you get it to me perfectly every single time. And so I always know when I get your files, I almost don't even have to check them, because I'm like, they've never given me a problem before. I do double check, but it's like, I just have so much more confidence that, like, and I have a better feeling. This is the key to all this kind of stuff. When I receive an email from those of you that always give me the files in exact right format, I feel better and I want to open an email from you, okay? That's the key right there. When you're working with a library and you're that producer, they'll want to hear from you. When you send them any email, right? Not just about, here's my final album or here's my final assets, but you send them any email saying, hey, what are you guys working on? Can I be a part of something? I'd like to help. You know, what are your clients looking for? What can I do? They're associating you and your email address with a positive response and a positive feeling. So guess what that's going to mean? More work for you, more opportunities, more opens, faster responses, more inclusion into a library, okay? These are the little details, devil's in the little details, but it really, really makes a big difference. So if I'm not pushing this stuff on you guys and letting you know this is so important, then I'm not doing my job. So I'll let you know what that consequence will be for the next opportunity. I'm going to kind of weigh it out there. But please, if you guys have any comments, questions, concerns, any confusion or anything like that, please comment below. I'd be happy to have a conversation with you guys about that. So thank you guys so much for watching. And again, don't make videos and drive. Totally not a good idea.